Kyle and Meredith, and this is The Kills with a new record called Ash and Ice. Ash and Ice. I don't always ask about the album title, but that one's cryptic enough that got me curious.
It's cryptic to us as well.
Yeah?
Yeah. It doesn't mean anything. Well, it does. It means, you know, like, really, I got this mixing desk and it made me write all these songs, and I had tons and tons of things that I'd got, and I had to name them all. Mm-hmm. So you kind of keep coming up with working titles, and I just ran out of ideas, really.
And I
put my cigarette out in my drink, and it was like Ash and Ice, that's good. And then it just kept sort of becoming something, didn't it? Just gradually started having more meaning.
I mean, it's a really good title. It probably needs a better story at this point, but
I'm going to think of one.
Yeah,
okay,
we need to work on it.
Well, there we were, and our house burnt to the ground, and we were standing on these ashes.
In the middle of winter.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Something
fire in the
like
middle
that.
Of winter.
So then we moved into an igloo.
Yeah.
It's a crazy good record. It really is, and it's you know, for a band who's, because you know, I know it's always been the concept for you guys to do something different every time, and that's gotta be exhausting. By the way, like I hear every band say that. Not every band. I hear a lot of bands say that. You know, like, we never try to repeat ourselves. Like, that's kind of a line the bands use, but that's not always really what happens with most bands. Just feel like,
sometimes
well,
it can't happen. I mean, you work really hard for it to happen, and at the end, you're like, damn.
Yeah.
But you know, it is the struggle.
And
making another record.
I like those bands that don't change as well. You know, like. You know, Nick Cave, he's found his thing. And
sure.
It's just, or like The Cramps, you know, it's just, I love bands like that.
Like, you know what you're getting into.
Yeah, but it was just, I'm not confident enough in that. And I can't sort of concentrate on one thing.
Yeah.
Especially with guitar music now, electric guitar music.
Which you've talked a lot about, your disillusion with where the guitar is.
I mean, I like a lot of guitar bands. I like the sound of guitar, but it just seems, I just think it's, you know, why is it that hip-hop is just going crazy right now?
Yeah.
Like, groundbreaking, was the freakiest, weirdest stuff. I mean, it, like, stuff like Future and, like, Kendrick Lamar's just like, come on, you know? And R&B, alternative R&B, is going crazy places.
This has been a conversation that I've
and
been having
guitar
so much
music,
that,
it's like, still sounds like either Nirvana or the Rolling Stones.
Sure, right. Well, there was, because there were two things happening, that's the way I saw it anyway. Like, there was the 90s comeback.
Yeah.
And so everybody right now, you know,
which I'm a fan of.
Doing that chunky.
But I just, you know, there's a difference between what I want to hear and what I want to play.
Well, what really kind of caught me off guard about, like, where you're talking about where hip-hop is and even pop music is, usually the musical movement always came from the underground. You know, it was the Nirvana or wherever. It was always the underground something. And this time it really feels like it came from the top. Because, you know, you go back just a few years ago, and once you start seeing Jay-Z and Beyonce start experimenting, and it gives a license to everybody else, you know, it's like, and now pop music becomes the thing we're looking at it going, oh, cool, this is the new movement. This is...
Yeah. It's true.
It's true.
And this seems to be where maybe you guys are borrowing from, or at least being inspired by.
By bigger things like pop
music?
With
this record, I guess. I do hear that. I hear that going on with
too,
this record.
I do too, yeah. I mean, it's sort of long been I've been fascinated with this, this, you know, styles of music and styles of production. And they kind of keep to their own camps quite often, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, it's rare to hear a sort of, I can't think of a guitar record. This is the kind of record I wanted to make. Mm-hmm. Like a guitar record that has like Lee Scratch Perry production.
Right.
I know Lee Scratch Perry worked with The Clash and all that, but it doesn't really, he didn't really do that much in the end. They didn't use all the, you know. But I sort of wanted that kind of dub production on a guitar record, or, you know, take a R&B production and put that on a sort of blues record, you know,
So do you guys go into that record then thinking like, I mean, is it usually like that? Is it like their concept or whatever, even the sound, like we have to shoot for this? Because you guys write separately.
Yeah.
You know, so to meet in the middle with the sound, do you have that, or does it just end up that way?
It kind of ends up that way through lots of pushing and pulling, because we both do write songs, and then I bring my songs in. They're always polar opposite end of the spectrum of the type of things Jamie's writing. So the Kills is really the combination of like jamming those two things together and finding some sort of
jamming them together
without jamming.
I was thinking of a beautiful sort of gilded bridge, you know, rather than just a hammer and trying to hammer them together. This is a thought out architectural structure that bridges me and you.
See, there's your poetry right there. That's the poetry. Well, so I bring that up. Lyrically, is there also the idea, like, you seem to be working double time because the Dead Weather and this. I mean, maybe not at the same time, I don't know. But like, there didn't look like there'd be the time off for you on that.
Like, was it much? No.
Yeah, I mean, so that's what I'm saying, though. I mean, lyrically, is there time to go, do you have to live to find the inspiration, or do you have to just sit down and think of the idea?
I write a lot, so, you know, those two things didn't clash. You know, when it's time to write Kill songs, I'm writing a lot of Kill songs, and I wrote a bunch before that Dead Weather thing, so we had a lot to work with and choose from. Yeah.
It was a little banked. And I have to ask, you know, we've been talking about, I know you're talking this story a lot about, but the finger, man.
Oh, yeah.
Like the story about you broke your finger.
Well, I used to have this thing called trigger finger, which means like, this doesn't move, you see. But in the mornings, my knuckles would lock up. My knuckles would lock up, and I'd have to go, pull them apart.
Yeah.
Because they would just stick. And so I started having cortisone injections in my knuckles, which I don't advise. It's the most painful thing ever.
I've had cortisone. It is very
in your
painful.
Knuckles?
No, not I had my knee, but I get it.
The guy, you know, I used to bite on some leather.
Yeah.
And he would just like, I'd have someone holding me down. And it was just horrific. And then I slammed it in the car door.
Yeah.
And crushed the end of it. And in his wisdom, my hand surgeon was a bit gung-ho, and he was like, let's do cortisone. He injected me with cortisone and a mixture of all this. I mean, I've heard it was like a 1 in 10 million chance.
Yeah.
But I got this deep bone infection and lost my tendon.
Oh.
They removed it.
Aren't you special? Congratulations.
Yeah, well, then I got a tendon transplant, and I can do that now.
Yeah, right. But that's I mean, did it... If you couldn't play guitar, would there still be a Kills? Because that's kind of what this is, it seems like, I guess.
I might need to get a little bit better at my instrument.
As long as I'm sitting somewhere nearby, it's still, she's the Kills.
Yeah, really. So it was never even a problem that you thought, like, maybe you were...
It was a scary, scary problem, it was. There's no doubt about it.
But it's sort of... the thing I discovered most was that I'm really, really positive. I never for a minute was kind of worried about it, really.
Yeah.
And then the only time, really, that I got thrown was when I saw everyone else's faces, you know. Mm-hmm. And I could tell that I was probably not being very realistic. And everyone looked really worried, you know, that I wouldn't be able to play guitar again. And it seemed like there was a time when it seemed like maybe we were winding this thing down. And I was like, whoa, no.
Yeah.
And so I just sort of committed to buying a load of studio gear. Because I just thought, I'm going to just be a one-handed producer. I'm going to chain her into the studio, play some. Yeah. But as it turns out, guitar's easy to play with this finger missing.
Nah. Well, once again, the 90s got away with it all the time. I mean, all you need is a couple power chords and you can get away with it.
Yeah, I think, you know, you find your style around all your, you know, little hindrances and disabilities. Like there's been a lot of great guitar players with no hands. No, Django Reinhardt, he had 1.5 fingers or something ridiculous.
You can be a drummer with no hands. You know, you can pull that off as well. So.
Yeah, but a drummer's not really a musician.
He said it.
I noticed that on our tour book. Did you see that? It said like Johnny, drummer. Scott, musician.
It's different.
Yeah.
There's a song I wanted to, I did want to bring up though. Hum for Your Buzz.
Yeah.
It's great. It's like a. I got it written down here. It's like the center. I mean, it is the center of the record. You put it right in the middle, but it actually feels like the centerpiece. It's like palate cleanser that you.
Nice.
It's so perfectly slotted in there. Is this your song? I'm catching by the look in your eye and everything.
I'm going like.
I'm going
it's
like.
It's you.
But it's also the different song on the record.
We almost started the record with it. We toyed with that idea. But then we weren't sure what people's sort of concentration span for whole albums is anymore, you know? Because it just felt like it would be such a nice start, and then suddenly the rest of the record's not like that afterwards. But
I guess that's what I cut from it, that it was an album move. It was, you know, it was the arc or whatever, which is nice and refreshing, and I would expect nothing less from you guys.
Is it the first? It's the first song on the B side of the vinyl, isn't it? On side two.
Don't know. Don't have it yet.
No.
I have a digital. There's no B side. It's
it's funny because I when we were sort of conceiving the art, you know, the artwork and the record and everything, Alison was constantly thinking in terms of vinyl, you know. Mm-hmm. When we were doing a track listing, she was like, I think side two should start with this. It was like, whoa, side two? I don't think of it like that anymore. And then it got thrown even more because it ended up being a double, so we've got four sides now, and a double vinyl.
That's really confusing.
I can't wait to see that. Can't wait to hold that in my hand. I should bring up, not that it's worth bringing up on my part, but the 14-year-old in me, of course, when I first heard Doing It to Death, I chuckled.
Why?
It's like, it's because, you know, in middle school, that would have been the sexual thing right there. It's like, really? Oh, you did it to death.
Really?
We're finding out new things about this.
Well, when
the
I heard
time.
You guys talk about, you know, the, you know, going for pleasure too much, you know, until it doesn't make I still thought that, you know.
I never heard that, but I mean, it was just really...
I don't think I should be too proud that I'm the one who brought that up the first time.
Breaking news. Yeah.
Not one of my better music journalist moments right
now.
No,
I mean, that's really interesting. Someone else said, like, oh, I liked it because it was really tongue-in-cheek. And I just thought, it's not really. It's like, what? I didn't know what they meant.
Well, it's a hell of a great song.
Thank
you. A perfect first single. And I do love Ash and Ice. And thank you so much, both of you guys.
Thank you.
Dropping by. It's a pleasure meeting you.
Yeah,
and good luck on your year.
Thanks.
Kills, Ash and Ice.